This is the VOA Special English Education Report. A study in Norway has found that students who stayed in school longer than others their age scored higher on intelligence tests. In the 1950s, the government began requiring students to attend school until the age of 16 instead of 14. Communities had almost 20 years to make the change. So some students went to school for 7 years, while others went for at least 9 years. This difference gave researchers the chance to see if the additional schooling had any effect on intellectual development. All young men in Norway must take a test of their cognitive ability at age 19 in preparation for required military service. This is commonly called an IQ or intelligence quotient test. University of Oslo researcher Taryn Ann Galloway says, "The young men who were basically forced to stay in school for 2 years longer actually did have higher IQs. So based on that, we were able to say that increasing compulsory schooling did actually have an effect on their cognitive abilities as measured at 19 years of age. An average IQ is 100. Most people score between 85 and 115. Ms. Galloway says students who attended school for 9 years scored 7 points higher than those who attended for 7 years. Those who went for 8 years scored about 4 points higher. The findings appear in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences. Experts have long debated the extent to which we are born with intelligence or develop it, influenced by environment and education. Another recent study in the journal Nature found that IQ scores can rise or fall during the teenage years. In 2004, researchers from University College London tested 33 young people ages 12 to 16. The researchers repeated the tests 4 years later. They found increases or decreases of as much as 20 points. Brain scans showed that as IQ scores increased, so did the density of gray matter in some areas of the students' brains. Professor Cathy Price says the differences in performance could be the result of some teens being early or late developers. But she says it is equally possible that education played a part. She sees a lesson for educators. We have to be careful not to write off poorer performers at an early stage, when in fact their IQ may improve significantly given a few more years. For VOA Special English, I'm Alex Villarreal.